When we set out to learn something, there is one thing we want to know right up front. How much time and effort will it take to master this topic? For that, it'll be good to understand the four stages of learning. Let's say you have an office colleague who stays close to you. He drives to work and is nice enough to pick you up in his car every day and you go to work together. You, on the other hand, don't know how to drive. You are in the first stage of unconscious incompetence. You are incompetent in driving and you are not even conscious of that. A time comes when you start to feel that you need to reciprocate. To do that, you realize that you need to learn driving. You have now reached the second stage of conscious incompetence. You are still incompetent in driving, but at least conscious of being incompetent. You then decide to take driving lessons. Very soon, you are driving, but are quite conscious of it. Okay, now I need to slow down. Now I need to look at the mirror. Now I need to change gears, and so on. You have successfully reached stage 3 of conscious competence. Competent in driving, but conscious of it. Finally, as you keep driving, it becomes second nature, almost automatic. You're listening to the radio, speaking to your co-passenger, and thinking of the day ahead as you drive. You are so competent, you're not even conscious of it. You have finally reached stage 4 of unconscious competence. So what does it take for us to move from one stage to the next? Moving from stage 1 to stage 2 is about awareness. For example, aware that I don't have a skill, aware that I speak too much or don't listen, aware how I'm perceived by others. It is critical to have that insight, but the change can happen in an instant, in an aha moment. Moving from stage 2 to stage 3 is about attitude. It is one thing to be aware, quite another to do something about it. It is also called the knowing-doing gap. My attitude can come in the way. For example, I don't need to learn driving. I don't listen, but that's okay. I'm perceived to be bossy, but I don't care. In our minds, we can rationalize. Only when we care do we decide to do something about it. We spring into action. Finally, moving from stage 3 to stage 4 is about mastery. It moves us from doing to a state of being, from managing anger to being calm, from doing coaching to being a coach, from leading a team to being a leader. This journey can take months, years, or even longer depending on what we take on. For instance, learning and applying concepts of emotional intelligence and empathy to being an emotionally intelligent leader can be a lifelong journey. So, wherever you are in your personal or professional lives, the question becomes, are you a lifelong learner by continuously uncovering what's blocking your potential and then actively working through them to attain mastery? Hi, this is Suman. Thanks for watching. I would love to hear your comments and questions. And don't forget to subscribe by clicking on the link below. Till next time, let us remember that leadership is an action, not a position. See you in the next one.